Do another round of Stardew Valley. Played this before, but I didn't get that far. I'm in about year two, so I'm gonna start over from scratch. We'll see how it goes. See here, farm name. I like... Let's do gaming. I did a cat last time. I'm gonna do a dog this time. I don't think it's that important. All the burns. This side burns are gonna win. Like how you can have any haircut you want. You can have some luscious locks. I go with the sideburns. I'm a farmer. I think I had to go with the overalls. Yep, so we go with the classic overalls. Oh, the sunglasses. Perfect. Eye color doesn't matter. Bright red. I think it looks beautiful. I am a champion. Poor grandpa. And for my very special grandson. I want you to have this sealed envelope. No, no, don't open it yet. Have patience. Really? But why? Now, listen close. There will come a day where you feel crushed by the burden of modern life. And your bright spirit will fade before a growing emptiness. That's sad. It's very depressing. I want that sword he has. When that happens, my boy, you'll be ready for this gift. Now let Grandpa rest. Good old Joja computer farm. I feel like this is my everyday life. It's a legit cowboy hat. I look so suave with my sunglasses. Dear Rubick, if you're reading this, you must be in dire need of a change. The same thing happened to me long ago. I lost sight of what mattered most in life, real connections with other people and nature. So I dropped everything and moved to the place I truly belong. I've enclosed the deed to that place, my pride and joy, Rubick's Farm. It's located in Stardew Valley on the southern coast. It's the perfect place to start your new life. This was my most precious gift of all, and now it's yours. I know you'll honor the family name, my boy. Good luck. Love, Grandpa. Aww. Oh, more stuff. P.S. If Lewis is still alive, say hi to the old guy for me, will ya? How long has this been? Like, 2 days? Stardew Valley. Let's do it. Let's farm some stuff. Hello, you must be Rubick's. Hey, Robin. I'm Robin, the local carpenter. Mayor Lewis sent me here to fetch you and show you the way to your new home. He is right there now. Tidying things up for your arrival. The farm's right over here if you'll follow me. No, I don't want to go. Why? This place is a mess. We need to keep the farm tidy. What's the matter? Sure, it's a bit overgrown, but there's some good soil underneath that mess. There better be. I'm going to be a poor guy. I just quit my job. With a little dedication, you'll have it cleaned up in no time. And here we are, your new home. Yay! Home. Ah, the new farmer. Welcome, I'm Lewis, Mayor of Pelican Town. You know, everyone's been asking about you. Really, I don't know about these people. It's not every day that someone new moves in. It's quite a big deal. So you're moving into your grandfather's old cottage. It's a good house, very rustic. Bullshit. I call it bullshit. Rustic, that's one way to put it. Crusty might be a little more apt, though. I'd agree. Don't listen to her, Rubick. She's just trying to make you dissatisfied so that you buy one of her house upgrades. Well, hopefully sooner rather than later. Anyway, you must be tired from the long journey. You should get some rest. Tomorrow you ought to explore the town a bit and introduce yourself. The townspeople would appreciate that. I will, Gramps. Oh, I almost forgot. If you have anything to sell, just place it in this box here, and I'll come by during the night to collect it. Well, good luck. Thanks, Gramps. Appreciate it. What's in here? Parsnip seeds. You've received 15 parsnip seeds. Here's a little something to get you started. Thanks, Gramps. A couple quests. If you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on the tilled soil to sow a crop. Water every day until the crop is ready for harvest. So I have to cultivate and harvest a parsnip. It'd be a nice gesture to introduce yourself around town. Some people might be anxious to meet the new farmer. Sounds like a plan. Let's check the TV. We got number one source for weather, news, and entertainment. Tomorrow's gonna be clear and sunny. Wellwick's Oracle, eh? Spirits are in good humor today. I think you'll have a little extra luck. That's good. Welcome to Living Off the Land. We're back again with another tip for y'all. Now listen up. This one's for all you greenhorns out there. Chop wood and search wild forage to earn some cash while waiting for your first harvest. Will do. So I've played this before a little bit. My first real goal is going to be plan everything, start that process, but also get enough wood so that I can repair the bridge and make some little extra money. Foraging. Six for now. I think the trees give you like, I don't know, find out, 12, 18. First things first is I need to plant my 15. Oh, and you can also have the setting where you can show the red tooltip. Where is that? Alright. Good. So now you can see where I am. The habit of doing 3x3s because of Harvest Moon. I don't think it really is required in this. Start out with 500 gold coins, whatever. Probably use those to buy a little bit more. Again, what I want to do is try to get the wood quickly so that I can make a little extra money. So that by the time I have to go to the flower or the egg drop festival, I think, I can afford a few of the strawberry seeds. Again, he might have patched some of this stuff that I experienced last week, so we'll find out. Pretty rapidly in here, so I'm gonna keep as many of the saplings as I can planted so that I don't have to worry about it later. Once I run out of energy here, I'll start exploring the town a little bit. Try to meet some of the folks. Another big thing in this game is you really need to keep at least one of everything, because something that will happen a little bit later. My goal right now is just to meet as many people as I can. So I don't have to do it later. Harvey, it's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Harvey, the local doctor. I perform regular checkups and medical procedures for all the residents of Pelican Town. It's rewarding work. I bet it is, Harvey. Hope you'll find your own work equally rewarding in time. I will. Let's go ahead and get you a flower. Oh, he loved it. One thing I really don't know is who likes what. This is just a calendar. Helps to know that all these people's names already, even though I haven't met them yet. Hey, it's Abigail. Oh, that's right. I heard someone who was moving on to that old farm. It's kind of a shame, really. I always enjoyed exploring those overgrown fields by myself. They'll still be overgrown for a while. Hey, it's Mr. Rubick's, the new farmer. I'm Pierre, owner of the local general store. If you're looking for seeds, my shop is the place to go. I'll also buy produce from you for a good price. I'm going to try to use the bin in all cases, just because you don't want to accidentally sell it to him, because it won't count towards your totals. A little agriculture can really inject new life into the local economy. Let's hope so. Let's see here. Really just want to clear out space. I do want some more parsnips. I can just, I'll just give this to her. So you can give, you know, if you look at the social, you can give each person 2 gifts a week. If you want to raise up their stuff, you really want to do that. Cauliflower is the best, but it takes so long to grow. And I really need the money before the festival. So I'm actually just going to buy a few more parsnip seeds. This is really cool. In order to upgrade your inventory, you need to buy this backpack upgraded for 2,000 gold. It's gonna be a little challenging to get that. Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie. Hey, Marnie. I sell livestock and animal care products at my ranch. You should swing by sometime. I will. Well, I'm not good enough friends with Abigail. The soundtrack to this game is awesome. Who's this dude? Hey, I'm Sam. Good to meet you. Well, that's all you have to say. Hello, it's nice to meet you. You too, Leah. Oh, you can still talk to you. You picked a good time to move here. The spring is lovely. It is. Hello there, I'm Gus, chef and owner of the Star Drop Saloon. Hey Gus. You're always welcome here. For some reason, some of them don't. You can just keep talking to them. I don't know. Oh, I don't have inventory space. So yeah, you can find shit in trash cans, which is pretty cool. Hey Benny. That's mean. You're the new guy, cool. See you around. Hey, Evelyn. Granny Evelyn. Yes, George, I hate meeting new people. Name's George, by the way, now buzz off. Guy after my own heart. Wow, I'm literally stuck. That was interesting. Oh, she doesn't like me. Can't wait to start cooking stuff. I think they all have a schedule, but I don't know the schedules by any means, so I just kind of wander. So the beach is a great place that you can look up, you can grab stuff. Crap. I shouldn't eat this leek. Give me a little bit more energy. I'm used to having a bigger inventory. Fish. I'll be back tomorrow. So leeks give you a tiny bit. I'll have to go back and put some stuff in the box. A tiny bit of energy, which is fantastic. Helps you stay awake. allows me to cut some more branches.